Hi, I'm Dimitri, and in this tutorial we'll go over tracking time with Clockify's desktop app for Windows. We can start by creating your account on the Clockify web app. And if you already have one, let's move on to installing the desktop app for your computer. You can download the app directly from our website. Click on this icon here and Clockify will be installed. Now log in with your email and manually type in your credentials, or log in with Google if you have your Clockify and Google accounts connected. Once you're in the app, you can start tracking time with either a timer or manually. You'll be in the timer mode by default, so you can click play to start the timer. To add more details to a running entry, click anywhere on the entry field, and then the window for details will open up. Now you can add exactly what you're working on. Add a project and a task, mark the entry as billable, and add tags if you need more details. This is really helpful when differentiating between entries in reports. Click Save to log the entered details, and stop the timer by clicking on the Stop button when you want to save the entry. If you forgot to start the timer immediately, you can edit the start time in the same way, by clicking on the entry, as well as change the end time or even the entry's date. Manual mode works in the same way. Switch to the manual mode by clicking on this list icon here. You'll notice that the blue button has changed to a plus sign. Click on it and then manually enter all of the time entry details. You can also restart the timer on previous logged activities by clicking on this little play button next to the entry duration. The timer will then start ticking with the same information, which you can further change as mentioned before. To clock your breaks, click on the little cup icon to change the timer to break mode. When this is enabled, the icon will change and you start and stop the timer by clicking on it. The break entry will be saved with the default break project that you've set in the web app. You can set that up here in the workspace settings. If you want to delete an entry, click on it, and then click on the bin icon in the bottom left and confirm. The desktop app will show you the total track time by day here and by week here. If you'd like more details, you can click on the settings icon at the top right. And then if you choose reports, it'll lead you to the reports page in the web app. Now I'll go over different settings, functions, and customization options that the desktop app offers. We'll start with preferences. The first group is the general settings. Here you can set your personalized shortcut to start and stop the timer, and to show or hide the app. Click the set button on the right, type in the keyboard shortcut you want to use, and you'll see Clockify pick it up. The next time you want to start the timer with your keyboard, you can use your shortcut. If you want to remove the shortcut, just click on the X and you'll be able to set a new one. Moving on, by enabling the Keep Clockify at the top option, the app will appear in your computer's taskbar. Take a look here. You'll notice the icon in the taskbar will be black if the timer's off, and blue if the timer's running. If you hover over the Clockify icon, a little window will pop up with details about the time you've tracked today, as well as the current running timer. Let's say that you want the app to automatically open as soon as you start your computer. Mark the Start Automatically when Computer Starts option, and your time tracking requirements and logging are taken care of. When you select the Default Project option, it'll be automatically set to the last tracked project. You can also choose a specific project by scrolling down the list. The next time you start the timer, the project field of the entry is already registered. And here you can change the theme of the app from the system's default to light or dark. And finally, we have Force Offline. This option ensures that your time entries are kept safe in the case that you lose your internet connection. When enabled, the Force Offline option will save copies of your time entries on your computer, so that the next time you connect to the internet, your entries will be synced up with the web app. Next up, the Reminders tab, which lets you customize the reminders you receive if you forget to start your timer. Once we click on the checkbox, this window will show up and we can start typing in when and how often we'd like to be reminded. And finally, we have the Timer tab. Here we can see multiple options for how your timer works for you. For starters, you can select that the timer starts as soon as you start the app. You can also choose to stop the timer if the screen is off, if your PC goes to sleep, or if your computer shuts down. To improve your productivity and control your working cycles, you can customize the Pomodoro timer. Just enter the duration in minutes for your work and break cycles. Clockify will then remind you when it's time to rest or get back to work. Another productivity hack is using the idle time option, which detects inactive time. You can set the length of inactive time that'll be considered idle. Later, when saving the entry, Clockify will warn you and give you a couple of options to deal with the detected idle time. You can discard idle time, which stops the timer and removes idle time. Discard and continue, which will immediately start a new timer. Keep idle time as part of the timer. Or add idle time as a new entry. That'll be all for the settings. Now we'll take a look at some features that come in handy. The Windows app also has an integrated screenshots feature. After screenshots are enabled in the workspace settings by an admin, users will be notified that the screenshot capturing is activated. You can check out your captured screenshots by clicking on the little camera icon here. Here you can revise the screenshots and delete some of the unnecessary ones that your admin doesn't need to see. Besides using a timer or manual mode to track your time, Clockify's desktop app also gives you the option to track hours with an automatic time tracker. Auto Tracker notes all of your desktop activity, which you can then revise, delete, edit, and convert to time entries. Let's see how it works by clicking on the A icon in the top left. This Auto Tracker window will open. When you click Start Recording, it'll start tracking your desktop activity. Recorded time logs in the Auto Tracker are visible only to you. After you finish your workday, you can stop the recording by clicking on the same button and then revising your day. The timeline will show you your activity during the day. If you click on a bar from the timeline, it'll automatically scroll you down to an entry that represents it. For each time slot, you'll see the name of the app or tool that's being used, more details on it in the description field, the link associated with it, start and end times, duration, and idle time. Idle time identifies time with no keyboard or mouse movement, so it helps you better understand your productivity or focus during the day. On the right side, you'll see a summary of time spent across apps or websites. Here, you can select all entries for a specific app by clicking on the checkbox here. And if you don't want to see this group view, click on this icon. To add a time log as a time entry, click on the plus icon on the right and add entry details and then click Save. If you have a specific activity in mind, you can navigate through the days by clicking on the arrows. Or use the search option to find the time log simply by typing a keyword. Instead of managing each time log individually, you can select multiple time logs by clicking on the checkbox, or select all by checking the box next to the App Name tab. Then you'll be able to add them as individual entries. Merge them in one. Or delete the selected entries from the Auto Tracker. Let's customize your Auto Tracker functionality. Click on the wheel icon to open the settings, and here you'll see some options. Firstly, you can hide the items from your list if you've added them as entries. The next option lets you exclude or include URLs of the visited sites or tools. And finally, you can customize the length of the time needed for an activity to be picked up by the Auto Tracker. And that was our tutorial on the Clockify app for Windows. Check out our other tutorials for more ways to track time using Clockify. Or you could visit our website or help center to learn more. Thanks for watching. See ya.